So the simulation that we're going to play here, again, the unit that we're doing is U.S. imperialism and impact on Latin American foreign affairs, okay? So this is the Monroe Doctrine game simulation. This is a game of to show you guys about foreign diplomacy. The simulation attempts to replay in simplified form the complex series of events that led to the Monroe Doctrine. After the simulation is finished, students will learn the way events actually played out in history. And you can see kind of the way I have you guys set up. Each group here is a country. You guys have your own all your name tags on there, right? You should have the United States. You guys here, Portugal. That should be Russia. You guys Russia? Yeah, so you can see I have the nameplates on there, okay? So you guys are each your own country. You're also be given a handout with your country's political situation on it with three questions to answer at the end after reading about your country's political situation. You also have those little blank cutouts, those little 4x4 cutouts. Those are going to be your telegrams, okay? You're going to send telegrams to make alliances, form treaties, declare war, and stuff like that, okay? This is one of my funnest games to play, because even my classes, you know, like some of the outliers usually aren't engaged, participate. By the end of it, you guys are going to be standing on your chairs, yelling at each other in world court, exposing each other. It's real fun. It's a real good engaging activity to kind of, you know, shows the complex nature of foreign diplomacy. Okay, so as I said, each team given a piece of paper about your country's political situation on it. Each team should read that paper in secret. Make sure you're reading it in secret. Even when you're making your telegrams, keep it in secret, okay? Secrecy is key because other teams might gain an unfair advantage if another team hears what you're saying. I'm going to give you guys about 10 minutes on this first. It's three phases. There's phase one, phase two, and phase three. Phase one is planning. Phase two is diplomacy. That's where you're going to be sending the telegrams, making alliances, and you're writing on the blank side. I just take extra worksheets and cut them up, so that's what's on the other side. But using the blank side to make your send your telegrams, make treaties, alliances, declare war, so on and so forth. Okay. So I'm going to give you guys phase one is 10 minutes, but I'm going to give you guys 5 minutes and stop halfway as a check-in on you guys. Each person on the team will be given a role during the planning stage, okay? I know the groups are a little lopsided, a lot of people are absent today. Normally you would have two planners. This person will write down the group's responses to the questions into their political situation cards to turn in. Then you would have two runners, or a runner and a writer. This person will be responsible for writing and sending the telegrams during step two of the simulation. Then you would have two speakers. These people will be like diplomats, basically, and these people will present the case before World Court during step three. But of course, like I said, the groups are a little uneven, lopsided due to absence, so on and so forth. So everybody's going to be work together as the planner. Everyone can be the runner and writer, and then I just need some. You can pick one person from your group to be the speaker. You really don't need two diplomats to say we're going to modify this activity. We're going to modify this activity to adapt to our current situation right now in class, okay? So does everyone have any questions, comments, or concerns? Does everyone understand what you have to do in phase one? Okay, I talked to people beforehand. I'm going to set 5 minutes on the board. That's when I'll talk to the people who I talked to before the activity, okay? 10 minutes, set the timer up. Alright, I'm going to put 5, like I said, it'll be 10 minutes all together, so I'm going to give 5 minutes just to check in with you guys. 5 minutes starting now, you guys can get started. Put some music on for you. Did you guys already kind of read it? Hey, Brady, come and join this group just so we have 4 over here. Appreciate it, buddy. Yes, you read them on already? No. Listen, one person is on one sheet, so one person is usually the planner who'll read through it and answer the questions and discuss with your other group. You good, buddy? Did you have a long Halloween? Late night last night? Trick or treating? Something like that? Any good Halloween parties? No? you guys are writing in the blanks, like I said, I just take old worksheets. Don't worry about what's on the other side. I've had people try to fill out and answer the questions on the other side and go, no, no. People I talk to, make sure you're doing your job. You'll see what's gonna happen when after the 5 minutes here. I tried to prop these day plates up to date. With years of use, they kind of got floppy on me. Don't see that anymore. Years, yeah. I've been doing this for years. My favorite game to play. They're pretty good condition.
What do you mean, look how?
That's why I've been in a little political situation last day. I don't know.
Yes, I have to read. I don't know what's going on. Yes.
You can always put them over. I guess you can put them over your laptop. There you go. Some students put them over their laptop like that, so that way you can kind of see. Yeah, wait 1 second. Let me start the second part of this. All right, 2 minute warning. What's up? Yeah, just answering the questions right now. Planning out your putting together your strategy. Yeah, you start writing on there. That's going to be in phase two. That's going to be diplomacy. You can start writing down right now where you want to make alliances. You know, this is just the brainstorming phase where you're going to read your political your country's political situation, answer the question, and based upon how you answer the question, that's who you're going to, you know. Hey, make sure you guys keep it quiet. Keep it secret, too. Don't be too loud. Other teams might gain an unfair advantage if they hear you. What's up, Aaron? Just can you wait 1 second before you pack this guy? You have to hear the announcement. The announcement's pretty important. You guys got 1 minute. I'm gonna check in, right, make an announcement. So will you do that? And you will? Okay, so then yes. And that's something that you're gonna, you know, based upon your political situation, how you respond. Like those are gonna start having to make alliances for those, you know. Thank you, Gabby, for paying attention. Thank you, Jada. Thank you, Alana. Thank you, Rachel. Thank you, Joris. Thank you, Talia. Thank you, Aaron. Thank you, Yvonne. Thank you, Celeste. Thank you, Josh. Thank you, Brandon. Thank you, everybody else. Gotta get all the voices off. All eyes and ears on me. In 5, 4, 3, 2. Wait on 2 people. Thanks, guys. Appreciate it. Okay, so before we started this, we have spies in the group, guys. So here's where, Jocelyn, you're going to go to your group, who you were a spy for the... You were a Russian spy, so you're going to move to Russia. And then Talia, you were a Latin American nationalist, so you're going to move over to Latin America. So yeah, I told the spies in the group now, what they were supposed to do is gather all the information Because now that after 5 minutes, you guys should kind of know what moves you're going to make. And now this kind of changes things up. This kind of changes your move because now Russia knows what America was going to do, and Latin America. Oh wait, I'm sorry. You were in the United States. You were a Russian spy. You're going here. Yes, there you go. That's right. I set that up right. And then you're going to go with Rayla over there. Okay. So. Who knows, there might be more spies, and there might be another round of them. All right, so I'll give you guys 5 more minutes now, because now you can kind of threw a wrench in your works, and you might have to reassess your game plan. So 5 minutes, spies, you make sure you expose, you know, discuss the information. What's up, Yvonne? What happened?
Excuse me?
Oh, do you?
Okay.
All right.
So y'all are going to get to spy.
Nope, I'm going to pause this for now. Here's my first edit.